concert, worship service. So thank you for being here tonight. Thank you. We have wheels to bless tonight that are motorcycles and cars and wheelchair and little types and a bicycle. So this is pretty exciting. So thanks for everybody coming out tonight. Well, I was thinking about blessing of the wheels. I was reminded of a time years and years ago. I was traveling back from a seminary and got a flat tire. Now, I'd been up at for a conference up in, I guess it was Johnson City, Kingsport or something. So I was coming back home, got a flat tire, pulled off to the side of the road, sitting somewhere outside of White Pine, thinking, now what am I going to do? Hey, sweetheart. Well, now you're going to preach.
That's what she's thinking.
And she's like, I could preach right now. So anyhow, I pulled off the side of the road and I was like, what am I going to do? So first thing I did was I called my daddy. Because that's what you do when you're a daddy's girl. You call daddy, right? And so I called dad and he was like, well, where are you? And I was, I don't know, somewhere outside of White Pine. And he said, well, I'll get my tools together. Go ahead and call AAA and we'll see what happens. So I called AAA and they said, well, we'll be there in an hour. So I called my dad back and he said, I'm going to start heading your way. Sit in the car. Stay buckled. Don't talk to strangers. So I'm sitting there in the car, and I'm sitting there, and I'm watching all these cars coming by so fast on the interstate. And my car, with the wind of their car, was making my car rock. I'm not going to lie, I got really scared, and I started crying. And I wish my dad was there right then and there. And as I was sitting there crying and praying, up comes a police officer, pulls up behind me. And I thought, well, I could probably talk to that stranger. That'd probably be pretty good. So I got out of my car, and he's walking towards me. He's got his hands, like, ready for the guns. And I get out of my car, and he's like, you got a problem? I just started wailing. I was crying. Oh, I'm so glad you were here. And he didn't know hardly what to do with all my tears, but I pointed to my tire, and he said, I can fix that. He said, no, I'm not supposed to fix it. So he said, you need to stand right here. He told me where to stand at the back of the car. And he said, look for traffic. And he said, I'm going to fix your tire. And he did. And he was my hero. We all need a hero. We all need someone to be there in the times that it's really hard for us. When we can't go any further, when we can't travel the road that we've been traveling on, when we get stuck or stopped, it's good to know that someone is coming for you. Now, for me, it was good to know my dad was on his way at some point in time. But I tell you, when I actually saw that police officer in the flesh, and I knew that he was going to be right there with me and not leave me, man, that was all I needed to know. And that's what we need, isn't it? Sometimes just to know that we are not alone. Someone is with us. You know, yesterday I had the opportunity to float down Beaver Creek with all that other 400 people who were going down for the flotilla. We fortunately waited till the very last to put our boats in. That was the smart decision because the crowd had gone on ahead of us and it was just pretty much our little group. And so as we're floating down the river, I'm leading our group from the church, those that came in. I have never been in a kayak. I do not claim to know how to kayak. I'm very thankful for Mark Graham providing a kayak that apparently kept me upright. Even with me not knowing what I was doing, but I sat in that kayak and I started floating down, taking that journey down the creek, thinking, I hope those people behind me know that I don't know what I'm doing, and they'll be there to rescue me should I get stuck. And sure enough, occasionally I got stuck on some trees or limbs or whatever, and someone would help me, and it was all good. And I bumped into a few boats, so I made some friends along the way, and so that part was good too. But I think what was most comforting and reassuring was as I was floating down that creek, every now and then I would say, Randy, are you still with me? Because Randy Cresswell was the boat right behind me. And every time, without doubt, he said, yes, Teresa, I'm here. And that was all the reassurance that I needed to know. And further on up the creek, as I shared earlier this morning, I could hear Brian teaching Joey how to paddle. And just his calm voice as he's teaching him how to hold the paddle. And Joey's, what, about something like that. It was just nice to know that I wasn't alone. We're going to take many trips in this world, and some of our journeys are not going to be pleasant. Matter of fact, we won't sign up to go there, and yet we will find ourselves in a tough place, a hard place, and we know we can't just stop and give up. We have to press on and push through and get to the other side. When I was in Israel, I had a chance to go to the place that's actually called the Valley of the Shadow of Death. And so when David writes in Psalm 23, "Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil." Standing on the edge of that cliff and looking down into that valley, I could see how he would pour out his heart in knowing that even though this was a lonely place for him, he wasn't going to stop there. He had more to do with his life, and he recognized that in that hard, rough, rocky place, God was with him. There's a story of a guy who, I think they were over in Africa, and he was a doctor over there for many, many years. And one day a man came in, and he was blind, but he needed cataract surgery, and this particular surgeon knew how to remove the cataracts. He did the surgery, and the guy's eyesight was completely restored. Can you imagine? He had gone for years thinking he would be forever blind until he met this man who could help him. And after that surgery, he was so grateful. He went on about his business. But about a month later, he comes back. He comes back to see that doctor, but he's not alone. And when he enters into the clinic, he's holding one end of a rope. And stretched out far behind him was this rope. And other people who were blind were holding onto that rope, going towards their healing. The doctor was amazed, and he said, I can't believe it. Some of them, they said, came 250 miles walking to get to this doctor to get their sight. Holding a rope, holding on to hope, holding on to one another. That's how we journey through this life together. And know that God is with us. Whether you are blind or you see, whether you are out in with a flat tire somewhere, oh yeah, that eats barbecue. Yes, the guy who's doing our barbecue tonight, he said on his way over here, before they left, they had a flat tire. So he said they're changing their tires. So I was over there blessing his vehicle when they first got here and thanking God that they were able to fix it, because that's their transportation. And that was good barbecue and street tacos, by the way. Was it not? Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Thank you. So just know that no matter where you're going, physically, emotionally, or spiritually, you do not go alone. But I also want to encourage you, when you have come through the valley of the shadow of death, when you have gotten your sight, for all that you are worth, please go back, bring a rope, or whatever wheel you got, or whatever you got, and bring others, so they know that there is a way through the dark times, and that they too can see that God is with them. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father God, we thank you for the gift of this day. We thank you for this time where we can gather out in this beautiful place and the breeze and wonderful music and barbecue. And thank you, Lord, that we are together. Help us, Lord, to know that we do not do this alone. And you did not create us to do it alone. We're not created to be on the outside lone wolves. We are created for community. Thank you for the community tonight. And Lord, we ask you to continue to bless our worship, bless the ministry at Beaver Ridge, and bless us in this community that we can be light to one another. Help us to see, Lord, as we go forth in this journey. In your Son's precious and holy name, amen.
Amen.
Now, they're going to come up and sing some more for us. And in And I'm going to be walking around and handing you out a prayer, and then we will bless the bikes when they are finished. Thank you.